from the people who brought you circles upon circles upon circles, and boss fights you will never see, which drop unique items you will never find, we now get Splinter League. In this natural evolution of the ARPG genre, we collect shards of artifacts from the graves of an old civilization. With all due respect of these ancestors, we will open the graves carefully. With TNT, understandably pissed off by this poor Looney Tunes ripoff, said ancestors rise from their graves to fight back. However, this time, we are the ones placing the circles and deciding which enemies to fight and which chests to open. Actual damage type immunities make sure the decision-making process, however, requires as much meaningful choice as deciding to not run a Fizzreflect map on your Impale Berserker. After defeating the pissed-off undead ancestors and collecting those relic shards, painstakingly by hand, from the ground, what will you do with all those shards, you ask? Because trading with other players is such a horrible experience in Path of Exile, trade boards are now an official part of the game. Oh, but the AI is worse, as some of them try to haggle instead of straight up putting you on ignore, as a proper trader would do. On top of that, PvP is now officially part of the game. No, it's not a meme this time. Yes, the good PvP mode is finally back. This is not a drill. Otherwise, Path of Exile is going back to its core roots. Copying Diablo. Creativity. Frozen orb, item-based gambling, hammer dins, damage immunities are now all copy-pasted into Path of Exile. And to shake up the metagame, a total of 90 new active skills and support gems are added to the game, one in line with each ascendancy class, such as Remote Cyclone, Stop Hitting Yourself, Banner of Boredom, Strike Skill Jebaited Support, Summon Rectangle, Summon Anime Bad Guy, Shocksick Rain, OP Clearing Skill, Nothing Personal Kid, Combination of Two Meme Playstyles, and many, many more. Remember when Chris Wilson posted about future patches having a narrower focus and less content? Yeah, me neither. But you know what will shake up the metagame even more than those skill gems ever could? Nerfing everything into the ground. On top of the usual nerf manifesto of Doom that we are used to by now, all damage granting support gems will be nerfed across the board, reducing overall DPS on any build by 20-40%. Yes, even your favorite build, especially your favorite build. Because triggered spells now cost mana. Spellslinger, cast on crit, cast while channeling, Mjolnir, trigger once. Yes, nothing is safe. You can like or dislike the direction the game is going with this, but such a vast and universal reduction in player power is a high-risk move and requires a massive pair of balls. But on the positive side, the long-awaited Flask rework is upon us. The short version is Flask Piano is fixed by making Flask not even worth pressing anymore. And even if they were, you barely get any Flask charges anymore anyways. Might as well throw them at your enemies instead at that point. Wait. That's actually a thing now. So while your death counter will be getting worse, your wrists might be getting better. To help with that, splinters will now drop as stacks, and different types of currency, such as alchemy shards, will drop as new unique items. So are you ready to deal 0 DPS, to not ever have flasks up anymore, to run out of mana on your cast on crit builds, to reroll cursed map mods all the time, to die to ailments for the first time in years, to get stuck in yellow maps, not to not being able to sustain, but due to being unable to kill blue mobs, to reroll builds with 10 different new skills during just the first weekend of the league, and to respectfully explode your ancestors for loot in Path of Exile Expedition.